Welcome to EduTube channel. Good manners. Manner refers to the way of doing something. Manners refers to the way a person behaves in society. Thus, manners can be good or bad, polite or impolite. For example, in our Myanmar culture and society, at mealtimes, it is bad manners for a junior to start eating before a senior does. It is always polite for a junior to listen with arms folded, while he or she is spoken to by a senior such as a parent or teacher. One important point to bear in mind is that every society and culture has its list of good and bad manners. Generally speaking, some manners are universal, while some are culture-specific. This means that a manner which is acceptable in one society may not be tolerated in another. For instance, belching or breaking wind in a company may be quite acceptable in one society, but not tolerated in another. In one's home or elsewhere, good manners are vital for a pleasant atmosphere and for getting on well in life. Thus, showing respect to the other person, offering help, greeting appropriately, and saying, "I'm sorry," when having done a wrong are all good manners. Now let us see how manners are acquired. Home may be considered the birthplace of manners. Children hear what the elders around them say, and see what the elders do. As they imitate their elders, they acquire their elders' manners. And there are times the father, mother, elder sister, or brother may formally teach the children to say or act politely. If the elders around them are gentle and polite, they grow up to be gentle and polite. If, on the other hand, the elders around them are crude and rude, they will grow up to be crude and rude as well. Next comes the school as an institution to impart good manners. Almost all children not only learn the school subjects their teachers teach, but also imitate the teacher's manners and behavior. In a school where teachers are good role models, students learn to be polite and respectful. In addition, they are quite likely to take their classmates and senior students to be role models, and here is the danger of acquiring ill manners. As we all know, teenagers and young adults are very often influenced by celebrities, films, and the type of books and articles they read. Hence, they are quite likely to be misled, and thereby acquire ill manners and negative views. There is still another institution that imparts manners, the work domain. Once a person gets a job, his work domain becomes an added institution to influence him, for good or evil. To put it in a nutshell, the current generation as a whole is the most powerful and most responsible institution for the imparting of good manners. The modeling of society is no easy task. All the elders of this generation should conscientiously join hands and teach their juniors to be law-abiding, upright, honest, self-respecting, disciplined, punctual, charitable, helpful, merciful, and forgiving. The quality of the next generation is in the hands of the present generation. As a matter of fact, we are mutually responsible for building a well-mannered society. Don't forget to click subscribe if you want more update on EduTube channel.